Using Dragon Naturally Speaking Pro, we're going to create a global command that will open Texas Instruments BA2 Plus emulator, which is a business calculator. And so we're going to enable this thing to be used with total hands-free operation. So in Dragon Naturally Speaking Pro, not the premium versions, not any other version, but the Pro version, I open it, click on Tools, and then add new command. And it pulls up a whole new window. You want to name that command whatever you're basically going to say. So we'll call it Open Calculator. Make sure it's in Global. And then we're going to select Macro Recorder and click Record. And then we do whatever we want it to do. So we open the calculator, go ahead and click on the clear, because that's what you always want to do. And pull up the recorder window, click on stop. And now we're going to have to train this thing. So you click on train, actually turn on the microphone, and then say open calculator after we hit click on go, and then we're done. And click on save, and so it's got it recorded. So the microphone is on. We're going to say open calculator. It recognizes the command, and it's going just as it did in the macro, even clicking on the clear. So that's how to do a global command in Dragon Naturally Speaking Pro. Okay, now I'm going to show you how to create a command that will actually be recognized to start clicking on certain keys. Now, you would have to create a new macro for every key. That's just what you're going to have to do. So we'll get started here and create one for one of the keys. Do the same thing, new command, and we're going to use the 3. This is going to be Windows specific, and it's going to be into a program that's already created and open. So selecting the window and the BA2 Plus MFC application, it was from a drop down in the application, and then we're going to tell it that we're going to record a macro for that specific application. Now this is different from creating a macro from a global perspective. This is within that window, so therein lies the difference and the real magic of the operation. So we've selected the macro recorder. We're going to click on record and actually select the 3 key. Now we're going to stop it, stop the macro, and now we need to train it. Turn on the microphone, click train, go, 3, and click on done. Save it, and it's done. The microphone's already on, so we're going to say 3. Let's clear that out. 3. 3. 3. 3. And it does it perfectly. So, good luck on making the rest of your keys and the rest of your macro operations.